That's the star. William Shatner. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Julie Harris. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olsen and friends. Now, shall we briskly get right to it?
Yes.
Yes, sir. All right. Okay. All right. We welcome all of you, and let's welcome Ellen Rowe now and Barbara Sowell. Barbara's current champ. She's won two games, has a total of $1,800. And she's very excited about that. She's been challenged by Barbara, who's had both of her questions and scored a total of four. And in a moment or so, we're going to find out what you do, Ellen. You're going to have to match four of our celebrities to stay in the game. Five, however, will win another game. Tune in a minute or so and find out what happens. Like a soap opera, isn't it?
Yeah.
Here we go. Push a button with my magic finger. And revealed the other question in our second round for Ellen. Remember, four to tie, five to win. Everyone plays. Optimistic Oliver always sees some good in everything.
Of course.
Now, in the kitchen, after Oliver cut off his finger, he said, "Well, I've got plenty of blank."
Good gravy, Marie.
Cut off his finger in the kitchen.
That's Optimistic Oliver. He cut off his finger while he was doing something in the kitchen. He said, "Well, I've got plenty of blank."
Oh, criminy Dutch.
That's good.
That's
all right.
Hard.
There are so many choices.
There are indeed.
I just got mine.
Well, no, there is one outstanding one.
Is that the outstanding choice?
Do you have it? Yes, that's it, of course.
Let me see yours.
Please, if I were playing, that's what I would have written.
I can't.
I put in a slot, Charles. We come over here to Ellen Rowe. Optimistic Oliver. You know, you've heard about him. He always sees something good in everything. In the kitchen, after Oliver cut off his finger, he said, "Well, I've got plenty of..."
Bandages.
Bandages. That was one possibility.
Yeah, that's bad.
Not the right one.
Not the one I thought of, Ellen. It may be the right one if they all say bandages. Certainly it's the right one, but you never know here. Bill, what'd you say?
I couldn't think. I mean, that is a... digits.
All right, you got plenty of digits. You know, plenty of other fingers, yeah. Got 10 altogether. What if I do cut off one?
Sorry,
what?
I have a niner, you know.
That's the answer. That's a very good answer. Brett?
I just took these out of here.
Yes.
She said, you can see they're wrinkled. A B... A B-A-N-D
Bandit.
And B-A-I, but I didn't write that.
What'd you write?
And I didn't write rhythm either. I wrote iodine.
Iodine?
Well, that's what you use. You just pour it on your
thing.
Oh, dear me, that's dreadful. Bandages is what she's looking for.
Optimistic Oliver.
Optimistic Oliver. If she doesn't match you, the
no
game is all over.
Because he has plenty of nine-finger gloves.
Nine-finger gloves. That means Barbara Sowell wins the game. What the rest of you have? Hold them up. Plenty of others. Come on down, Barbara. Congratulations to you. We wait there a moment or so. Well, Ellen, we're going to part company.
Okay.
Now, you've got $1,800, and you're going to have your baby in about a month or so, a month and a half. We wish you the best of luck in that blessed event, and it was marvelous meeting you.
Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Now, here we are with Barbara Sowell. This is her first game. She's going to try... and win over $5,000 now. And if you're ready, we'll just get right to it, okay?
Let's do it.
We polled a recent studio audience, Barbara, and we got their best response to this. Rick Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. The bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on over here?
Let's try Julie Harris.
Let's try Julie Harris. How would you fill in that blank, Julie? Rick.
Rack.
Rick Rack. Okay.
Rick Rack.
All right, there's one.
Richard?
What do you say, Richard?
Rickshaw.
Rickshaw. Rickshaw. Okay, you got two now.
Fanny Flagg.
Rick Nelson!
Now,
I still say rickshaw.
You'll say rickshaw. Well,
you keep continuing to say that.
She says Rick Nelson. Now, there are the three. Rick Rack, Rick Nelson, Rick Shaw. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better idea in your own mind?
My first reaction was Rick Nelson. I think I'll choose that.
That. You're not letting this audience influence you, because they could be a bunch of dummies sitting out there.
Oh, but Fanny.
Or, you know, Fanny did it with such showbiz pizzazz. Rick Nelson! That maybe says, oh, that's a good idea. What do they know there? All right, she says Rick Nelson, what she wants. We'll find out if Rick Nelson is up there. Shall we all reveal the $100 response?
Yes.
Rickshaw.
Ha-ha!
Uh-huh.
Ha-ha! Uh-huh. He said it's got to be Rickshaw. He sat up here and said it's got
to
be Rickshaw.
For the 100.
Relationship
all right.
To George Bernard.
She's looking for Rick Nelson. Let's find out if it's under the $250 response. Rick Rack, that's Julie Harris's answer. That's good. That would have been worth $2,500 to you. Last chance for Rick Nelson. Here is the $500 response. Nelson! Very good. Okay. Well done, Barbara. You're up to $600 now. But more important than that, it means you're going to play for 10 times 500 or $5,000. And to collect that amount of money, you're going to have to match one of them. This is a head-to-head match, and it has to be an exact match. Which one will it be?
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. And,
Nelson.
I'll get the $5,000 question out of the slot here, and this is the way it goes. Above blank. A-B-O-V-E, above blank. Above blank. Above blank. It's a hard one, isn't it?
Well, there's a couple that are the same sort of string.
Now, Richard's given us his answer. He's written it down. He's put it in a slot. And we ask you now to give us an answer which you think will match his. Above blank.
Above ground.
Above ground. What are you moaning at that? Are you moaning again? You're the moaningest bunch we've ever had in here. Above ground, she says, Richard, will match it for $5,000.
But the one is above and beyond. The one I said was above board.
Above board. Yeah. Yeah. Above all is another one. Above ground is not bad. Above board is good, too. What's that?
Above reproach.
Above suspicion.
Below suspicion.
Above and beyond the call of duty.
Above and beyond the call of duty. There's no room on the card for all that there. All right, Barbara, you've got your $600. You're going to meet another player in a moment or so after we do a little business with America. We are ready to carry on and play another game. To do that, we welcome another player. Let's all welcome Mr. Samuel Frustacci.
Thank you.
Hello, Sam.
Hi, how are you?
Everybody call you Sam?
You bet.
All right.
Fine.
You know this nice lady here?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. Now, Sam, we'd like to find out where you're from and who you are and all that.
Okay. I'm originally from Los Angeles, California. I've just returned from back east in East Coast doing missionary work with different trying to strengthen family unity and things of this nature to make a
you mean
better
in the
place.
Eastern part of the United
you
States?
You bet. I was back in the nation's capital.
Oh, I mean, do they need a lot of that there?
Is
that
no,
more than here?
Well, I think we need it all over the world. I think that if the family unit is strong, I think the nation will be stronger.
Uh-huh. Well, that's a good idea, Sam. We congratulate you on that work.
Thank you very much.
All right. Good luck to you. As the challenger, we ask you to make a selection.
Okay, I'll take B, please.
B it is.
Family, Sam?
No, I'm single.
Oh.
Where do you get off telling us how to handle our
family?
You have your family and then come back and check.
I had a good upbringing.
Don't hear me going around.
That's right. Charles, what did you say? What? You got your fingers crossed?
Sure, I hope it's not a cannibal question.
Why?
Well, he's a missionary.
Oh, he's a missionary. Oh, I'm sorry. No danger. Here it is. It's a Tiny Tom Thumb question.
Oh.
While Tiny Tom Thumb was visiting his regular size neighbor, Tiny Tom decided to end it all. Isn't this a cheerful thing we're giving you here? Tiny Tom decided to end it all, so Tiny got up, walked into the kitchen, and jumped into the blank. That's the way Tiny Tom.
Wait, does the first part of the question have anything to do with the last part?
Well, he was visiting his regular size neighbor when he decided to end it all, so he got up, walked into the kitchen, and jumped into the blank.
That's easy enough.
That easy?
Yes.
Okay, that's one possibility. That's a good possibility there. That'll do it, in any case.
Every time.
Every time. Okay, Brett, are you writing?
Yeah, oh, darling, I'm all through.
19 cards again. All right. Samuel, you know who Tiny Tom Thumb was.
Not, well, whatever, I can't remember.
You can't remember who Tiny Tom Thumb?
No.
But there was a real man once,
okay,
many years ago, who was discovered by the great circus impresario, P.T. Barnum, and he discovered a man who was about, I don't know, so big, a really tiny man, and he named him Tiny Tom Thumb. And he was small. He was really, yes.
Wallet size.
Yes, wallet size, yeah. That's very good for a missionary. Wallet size. Got a lot of laughs in Washington, I bet, huh?
Yeah, you bet.
A lot of laughs. Well, they need a few laughs there these days. Anyway, while Tiny Tom Thumb was visiting his regular-sized neighbor, who must have been all of 5'2", Tiny Tom decided to end it all. So he got up, walked into the kitchen, and jumped into the blank.
I'd say garbage disposal.
Garbage disposal. You rascal, you did know who Tiny Tom was all the time. Then he pretended he didn't know who Tiny Tom was. Now, what do you say, Bill?
Well, I'm just taking from his answer, you can imagine what Tiny Thumb said when he jumped into the garbage disposal. He was saying, "Press the button! Press the button!" Garbage disposal.
Disposal. That's one for Sam. You look a little depressed, Brett.
Well, I'm dispirited. I live eternally in the past. I never seem to come right up to things like garbage disposal. I said, oh, wait a minute. I said tea kettle, not pot, which is different. I didn't want it to be confused, you
right,
see, because I was so sure I was right. Wait a minute, dear. I haven't finished yet. Go ahead.
Charles?
Unbelievable. I said disposal because I will not let a missionary down.
All right. Super Sam. Julie, are you going to let that man down?
I'm afraid I have to.
You are afraid.
Oh. I said he jumped into the...
Go.
Mousetrap.
Into the mousetrap. That'll do it. And boy, it'll hurt, too.
I like Julie's answer.
That's not bad. Yeah, that'll do it.
That's
Richard, are you going to let this man down?
As long as he doesn't tell me any more about the family. Garbage to say.
Miss Fanny, honey.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
Good.
Garbage disposal.
There's another one. That's not bad for a first round, is it? You got started off that way, so that's four for him. Your first round question is yet to come, but right now this is coming your way. Now, we go to the second half of round one. Barbara, this is all yours. Listen carefully. Here it is. Weird Willie.
Yes, I'm right here.
No, no. Weird Willie has...
You want me, sir?
Weird Willie has a specially made mattress.
Oh. How specially made is it?
I'll tell you how specially made is
That's...
it. Instead of it being stuffed with goose down, Weird Willie's mattress is stuffed with goose blank. That's how Weird Willie is. He has a mattress stuffed with goose blank.
All right, just for that.
Oh, dear me, it's so much fun being in show business. Is this really show business?
I never thought it was until I saw Miss Harris.
Yes.
That's a
pleasure to do business with you. I tell you what we do to newcomers. We kiss a lot.
Thank you,
Gene. Now, hey, listen, who is that?
What?
You've done that. Oh, you're ready. Okay, I'll ask you about it later. Barbara, Weird Willie has a specially made mattress. Instead of it being stuffed with goose down, Weird Willie's mattress is stuffed with goose...
Liver.
Liver. Oh. What's wrong with that? Do you know how weird this guy was?
Yes, sir.
He was a liver freak. Hello, Bill.
Yes.
Hello, Gene.
Listen, on
what?
CBS.
Yes.
Next month.
Yes. Oh, you do that Playhouse 90. Yeah?
I think you
I heard
take
about
a look.
That.
It's called The 10th Level. It's on
yes.
CBS December 18th.
Okay, we'll look forward to seeing it. Watch that. That's an order. And remember, you must obey orders or you'll be in big trouble.
That's kind of what The 10th Level's about. if this was Weird Willie,
yeah,
he really liked to get a charge out of things, and he loved it to be stuffed with goose beaks.
Goose beaks?
Well, goose beaks.
That would hurt.
That
would hurt.
That's what he said, all right. Every time you lay down.
Ooh. Who is that weirdo in the audience? Gives it.
You.
You. Get out.
Well, he realized that a bed stuffed with goose beaks was a snap.
Right. Oh, yes, of course. Oh. Do not compound your errors. Brett, you're up.
What do you give me when we go to that motel in Encino? Goose pimple.
Goose pimple. Come on, Charles, be serious.
And what does the owner of the motel get every time he sees you two pulling up, goose?
Goose.
You're next in the motel in Encino. Now, what do you say?
Liver.
Goose liver.
Ah, there's one. Let's hear the dinner.
Weird Willie is a specially made mattress. Instead of being stuffed with goose down, Weird Willie's mattress is stuffed with goose up. Goose up.
Now, wait a minute. Are you trying to tell me that you... Did they think of that all along?
Yes.
Is that what you were thinking of all along?
I thought of people.
As I have said many times on other occasions, I am surrounded by weirdos, including you.
Weird Willie.
Hello, Fanny,
you
darling.
Know, you get upset with this show sometimes, you know, so I want to talk to you about what this show really is. A little bit, something happened to me. A lot of people watch this show you don't realize. I was on the show last week, and a famous Broadway producer watched it. He was ill. You never know who's watching.
Right.
And he called me up, and he assured me that I would never be in any of his plays. But
does that... tell you something, Julie? you've had it for Broadway.
I don't believe it.
That you were on here.
No, that is concerned. No. I said live airs.
Who's live airs? Yeah. There's another match for Barbara. So at the end of round one, score is 4-2 in favor of Sam. We go to round two now. And, Sam, we ask you to make a decision here.
B, please.
B it is. Yes, you ready, Sam?
Yes, sir.
You matched four celebrities last time, so that means they lay out and only two play. Julie, you play, and Brett, you play.
Okay.
Here it is. Gloria said, my husband is acting very strange lately. When I bought him a new pair of shorts, he put them on over his blank. Bought him a new pair of shorts.
Oh, my husband is acting very strange.
My husband is acting strange lately.
I got it.
When I bought him a new pair of shorts, he put them on over his blank. Okay, she's finished. All right. How strange was he? Well, I'll tell you. Hey, Sam. Gloria said, my husband is acting very strange lately. When I bought him a new pair of shorts, he put them on over his...
face.
Face. Yes.
May I just say that the two answers that are about to be shown network...
Yes.
...will make history. I will just sit back, as will the nation.
All right, get your own show, Charles. Let me hear
you. He said he was strange, right?
Strange.
He's very strange.
Show us.
He put them on over his dress.
Oh, no. Sorry, Sam. And you, yes.
Read your question.
Gloria said my husband's acting very strange lately. When I bought him a new pair of shorts, he put them on over his...
electric light.
Yes! Well, we said he was weird and strange, but I didn't know he was that weird. So, at the end, in the middle of round two, 4-2, and we've got to stop right now and do a little business, and then you hurry back and see what's going to happen. Because we don't know. I must say, you were all more than adequate. Now, this is Gene Rayburn from Match Game 75 asking you to join us.